Dad's in studio. He's visiting me. So we'll take a few moments here and answer some comments that have come into our YouTube channel. First question, Dad. This came in on our video where it's about a heat pump runs nonstop. This person is saying, thanks for this information. You have also described my heat pump in low temperature situations. My question is, if I am away and the temperatures drop into sub-freezing temperatures, will the auxiliary heat come on if necessary to maintain the in-house temperature?
Yes, if everything is working properly, it should.
Okay.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Okay, I thought you might take longer with that one. Okay.
And what they're meaning by that is it's typically done by the thermostat. You typically have what we call a two-stage thermostat. And so the first stage that it calls for is going to be your heat pump operation. That's the most economical heat. But as it gets colder outside, what they're referring to, as it gets colder outside, there's less heat available out there. So it tends to run longer to generate the same amount of heat. And so at some point, that thermostat on the wall, the temperature isn't keeping up. The room temperature has dropped enough to bring on the first stage. Well, now if it continues to be cold outside and we aren't generating enough heat with the first stage, it will then drop the second bulb, which means it's going to now turn on the electric heat from downstairs and run both of, typically you run both of them simultaneously. You still keep running the heat pump, but you give it some auxiliary heat help to heat the homes. Sometimes it'll stay like that. It'll stay with both stages running until the thermostat is satisfied. Once it's satisfied, it shuts off, everything shuts off, and the next call for heat is gonna start out all over again with just first stage, and it's gonna try and heat the home with just first stage. But yeah, that's it should take care of it.
I knew you had more to say.
Yeah.
It's
never a short answer.
You usually are not a man of few words when it comes to this stuff. Okay. So remember that video I just posted a couple weeks ago where we showed the full installation of a new system where we went from two systems to one. This person is commenting on that and he says, dope metalwork. So good job. Shout out to the installers. Small question, and that's, do you guys insulate your ducts afterwards? And if not, why? Just wondering because my company and the nearby ones I'm familiar with also insulate and we use bubble wrap or fiberglass.
Typically, we do not insulate the ductwork. Most of our installations are in conditioned spaces. They're down in a basement area where there's not a whole lot to be gained or lost in it. So no, we really don't. Though there is absolutely nothing wrong with insulating. Insulating on the interior of the ductwork is extremely nice. I've had jobs at my own home where I've insulated all my ductwork. And I didn't do it for temperature considerations, it was for sound.
It's just quiet.
You can just make it so quiet with all the ductwork insulated. So no, we typically don't. The bubble wrap type stuff, yes, we'll use. It's easy to use. It's really not as efficient as some of the other wraps, meaning if installed properly, they have to stand off of the ductwork. You have to create a spacer, and it's a little more involved if you really want to do it properly the way the instructions say. But no, there's nothing wrong with that, but we typically do not.
Yeah, we do a lot of, in our area, most of that stuff is in the basement and it's conditioned and it's not like it's an attic.
However, we always insulate if it's in an unconditioned space, going through the attic space or something like that, or sometimes even in certain crawl spaces and things like that,
Yes.
Yeah, we definitely insulate.
Right.